Don't just hire the attorney your friend hired because they had a good experience, because every divorce is totally different, right? Your needs are totally different than your friend's needs, and your friend, you might think they confide in you a lot. They may have actually hit a lot of things about their divorce because this is really personal, right? You don't feel comfortable telling everybody about it. So you don't know that their experience is going to be your experience even with that one attorney, right? So everybody has different things that they're good at in this area of the law. Some people are really great at the finances. They're like really financial wonks. And if you have a really complicated financial case, you want that attorney. That attorney who really like can look at a tax return quickly and parse out all the details. If you have multiple children and they're the most important part of your divorce, you might want an attorney who's really sensitive to those issues, who has a lot of background dealing with co-parenting. That might be the most important thing. Ultimately, when you sit in that initial consultation with an attorney, and I always recommend having an initial consultation, which is really like a meet and greet, you should leave that meeting feeling like you were educated by them in the divorce process. So there should be a value add. It's not just like, do I like this person? You should feel comfortable talking about intimate details of your life with this person. I mean, divorce is so personal. It can involve things that you don't really tell your friends or family about, your finances or your personal spending or your kids or your sex life even. And this is somebody you're gonna really have a relationship with for a period of months, maybe years, and you're gonna wanna be as honest with them as possible. So make sure that you feel really comfortable in that meeting that this is somebody I'd like to work with. Not just that I feel comfortable this person's going to go get my spouse. I mean, that's not ultimately the most important thing. They're going to be your partner, so make sure you feel good about that. A financial advisor being hired at the beginning of the process can really help you think through, what's a smart financial settlement look like for me? What's a personal budget I can live with after divorce, and what does that mean in terms of my support needs? So hiring that person towards the beginning is really smart, and attorneys in the divorce field, they may be good at that, but that's not their focus. So that's somebody who usually charges less than an attorney on an hourly rate, but can give you more strategic advice on that one topic. And your attorney might have somebody they really like working with that they can recommend. I really cannot stress enough how just even a couple meetings with those people can be so valuable. Also, divorce coaching. Divorce coaches can be really great for helping you get the most out of your meetings with your attorney. Again, they're gonna be probably billing at a lower rate than your attorney does. And so those days you just feel like you wanna tell someone you're overwhelmed and you don't know what to do and you feel like you're stuck, that's the person you should call. I mean, your attorney is not necessarily the best person to call in that situation. I mean, when you get that first bill from your attorney and you see how much that 30-minute call cost you, where you don't feel like you really did anything but spin your wheels, that's going to really hurt. So I think be careful about that and use coaches for what they're good at. And they're good at so many things. Helping you prep, helping you make most efficient use of your time with your other professionals is a big one. The third tip is educate yourself with reliable information. It is so easy to fall down the internet rabbit hole of divorce advice, reading a blog here, reading a blog there, going to this message group, this forum. Every divorce is different and every state has different divorce laws. So what you read on a blog that's an attorney from one state might not pertain to you at all. So don't get too fixated on anything you read online. Make sure what you're reading is really, like if you're gonna read about the tax implications of your divorce settlement, for example, look at the IRS publication on that. I mean, it might not be the most readable thing, but it's gonna be the most reliable thing. So just think about where you're getting your information from. My fourth tip is to not be afraid to ask questions. Your attorney is gonna send you that first bill. You're gonna be like, whoa, how did this happen? And it's okay to call them and say, hey, I just wanna walk through my bill. I just would love to know how I got to this total and really understand it. And maybe I could do better next month and use you more efficiently. When I get a client ask me that, I'm so happy to have that conversation. It doesn't make me want to work for them less. It doesn't make me resent them. I want them to get the bill from me and feel like it was worth it. Don't drag it out too much. Yes, move at the pace that feels comfortable to you, but know there are no winners in divorce. If you try to win every issue, you're gonna get really bogged down. It's gonna take way longer than you want, and it's going to, at the end, become very unaffordable. So really focus on what are your non-negotiables, what is your most important thing, and focus on those. Make sure the professionals you're working with know what those are. If it's keeping the house, if it's getting the majority of nights with your kids, if it's keeping your kids in the same school district, whatever it is, just make sure your professionals know what your priorities are and try to stay focused on those, because it's so easy to get bogged down in the nitty-gritty of every little decision. And again, you're not going to leave your divorce feeling like you won. Like, everyone's going to compromise, and that's just the reality of it.